Hey there, lads and ladies, it is Petrifying Pumpkins here, and welcome to another episode of PSVR News. This one's going to be kind of brief, I guess. There's only two big things I wanted to talk about. One of those things I'm late to the party on anyway, so we leave that for that. But the big thing I want to talk about, I guess, is the Resident Evil thing. So I guess we'll just jump right into that. Before we do, if you like this video, then help me out with a like, subscribe, all that usual shite. That would help me out big time. With that out of the way, let's just jump right into it. So I'm sure many of you are aware already, but yesterday there was a Resident Evil Ace Village showcase. And of course, all of us in the PSVR community were kind of keeping a close eye on this because, you know, Resident Evil 7 had PSVR support. It is still my favorite PSVR game, Resident Evil 7. So I was really, really hoping we would see confirmation that Resident Evil Ace would also have PSVR support. And while the event was about like 20 something minutes long, it gave the release dates, it showed off a new trailer, it showed off a PS4 version and a last gen version, I guess I should say, for Xbox as well. And that did give hope, because if it has a PS4 version, there's a good chance it would have a PSVR version. But alas, there was no mention made of a PSVR version whatsoever, and that was a bit of a huge kick to the balls. Now, that's not to say it's definitely not happening, but you would imagine they would have said something here at this event. We're only 5 months out from launch of this game now. So this is the kind of thing you'd want to be talking about, unless maybe Sony have something planned themselves, like a state of play that's VR centered. Maybe they want to announce it themselves. That is a possibility. Capcom and Sony have been teaming up for marketing for this game since it was revealed back in June. So that is a possibility. Now, is there anything we can do? Well, there possibly is one thing. I was browsing Reddit and I found this link. I'll put it up on the screen here beside me. Basically, it's a survey. You can click on the link. There'll be a bunch of questions about the showcase, and they basically give you lots of opportunities to type stuff in yourself about what you wanted to see, what would have made it better. I know when I did this, I was like, well, it would have been better if there was VR support. So I will put the link in the description. You can click on that. Maybe if there's a surge of people who are interested in VR support, Capcom might consider it or might take it more seriously. And I must say that I don't know why they haven't already, because according to the Resident Evil 7 statistic page, where, you know, all the stats are gathered from all the players and posted to this website where they keep track of all these different stats, apparently the number of PSVR players has crossed over 1 million, which is a pretty significant amount of PSVR owners. I think we've only got like 5 million headsets out in the wild. We haven't hit that 6 million milestone yet. So the fact that there's 1 million have played Resident Evil 7, that's like a 20% attach rate, which is pretty huge for a VR game, for any PlayStation game. So yeah, kind of sad news there when it comes to Resident Evil Ace. Fingers crossed something can happen in the future which will change things. Maybe a PSVR 2 announcement could come along and save the day, but that won't be for a while yet anyway. We just have to kind of keep our fingers crossed and hope that Capcom or Sony or whoever it is who calls the shots on these things, you know, maybe Sony need to pay up. Maybe they need to fork over a fat stack of cash to make this happen. Whatever it is, I hope it just happens so we can have it, because the game looks incredible. I played the demo on the PS5, the Maiden demo it's called. That looks fantastic. I'd love to try the demo on PSVR like you could with the demo for Resident Evil 7. So yeah, despite just getting Hitman, and I know I feel like, you know, maybe I'm being greedy or whatever, but Hitman is so excellent from what I've played so far. I feel like maybe I'm being a bit entitled or whatever, whinging for another AAA VR port so soon, but come on. I mean, you all know. We're all on the same page here, I think. Anyway, with that being said, make sure you check out the link to that survey. Let them know what you want. And of course, what you want is VR. Let them know you want VR. Even if you don't want VR, you let them know you want VR. All right? Spread the word. Share that link everywhere. And let's move on to story number two. Bullet Roulette VR has arrived for PSVR. Now, you may remember all the way back in April of 2020. Back when COVID-19 was just, you know, starting to take over the world. I guess it was already over the world at that stage. But whatever. I personally made a video saying that Bullet Roulette was coming to PSVR. You know, I had that hot scoop because I did a little detective work. I did some digging. I googled, you know, I used the googles, and I came up with the, you know, the inconclusive proof that Bullet Roulette was coming to PSVR. Nobody believed me, of course. I was shunned by the VR community. But I've been vindicated, because out of nowhere, it just dropped. So you can buy this game right now, and it is dirt cheap. Now, I will say the game itself is kind of, I worry about how much replayability it would have, I should say. So basically, you're playing Russian roulette with up to three of your friends, so four players total online. You can play with friends and with randoms, but you know, it's probably a lot better with friends. The game itself for me cost €8.99. I think it's roughly the same in dollars and something similar in sterling. Well, it doesn't go over a tenner anywhere, I don't think, unless maybe Canadians or whatever, you know. But you know, the maple syrup tax, whatever it is going on over there. But anyway, my concern about this game is that maybe it gets a bit repetitive after a while, but I think it could be a nice little palate cleanser. A game like this, I think maybe a few drinks, whatever, you can have a lot of fun. It does look like, you know, there's plenty of lols and bans to be had. When I get the chance to be streaming this game, I will be streaming this for sure. I've already bought this, it's a download, so I'm looking forward to playing this. You will need your Move controllers first, but other than that, you'll be good to go. And from the reviews I've seen so far, I think everyone's been pretty positive about it, as long as you take some things into consideration, you know, made by a small developer, you know, and that comes with certain things that you should probably expect. Anyway, that is it for this episode of PSVR News. Thank you very much for watching. But before I go, let me give a huge shout out to my Patreon supporters whose names are on the screen as we speak. Thanks to their generosity, they're helping keep this channel lovely and moist. In particular, let me give a shout out to the following top tier Patreon supporters: Chopped517, Tradition, Crumb, Pete Hawkins, Columbus Thomas III, Daniel the Pumpkin Patch Kid. Thanks to your generosity, you're keeping this channel going. If you'd like to support me over on the Patreon, the link to that will be in the description, patreon.com/petrifyingpumpkins. If not, I'll be happy with the likes, the subscribes, the comments, you know, discussion, sharing, everything that helps with the YouTube and shites will be appreciated. And finally, let me thank Decepticon for letting me use his music in all of my videos. Thank you very much, Decepticon. You can find him in the links below as well, Decepticon.com. He's on Spotify, he's on Bandcamp, he's on all these places that you'll be listening to your music to. And I believe he's working on a new album as we speak, so look forward to that. So that is it for this video, lads and ladies. Please stay nice and moist.